Many important figures are evident when you hear the word the Underground Railroad. You may heard of Harriet Tubman or Frederick Douglass, but many others contributed to the success of the Underground Railroad. One of these contributors is called John Fairfield. He is responsible for the freedom of hundreds and maybe even thousands of slaves, and he's not afraid to remove anyone who stands in his way. Back in John Fairfield's childhood, he was born into a slaveholding family in Virginia. There, he disagreed with their practices, and at the age of 20, he helped his childhood friend escape into Ohio. Upon his return, his uncle had planned for his arrest. This engaged him to start his part in the Underground Railroad. Soon after his return, he led a group of slaves from his uncle's farm through the Appalachian Mountains to freedom. John Fairfield's role in the Underground Railroad was often referred as the conductor, as he conducted many organized ways of leading slaves to freedom. He was famous for reuniting broken slave families and his creative, unusual, and inventive ways for fighting slavery. Although John Fairfield may have made many amazing feats, one of his most innovative is him being disguised as an undertaker in the funeral procession, helping more than 28 slaves escape to freedom. This does not mark the end of his ideas. He will even go far lengths, like taking months to associate with the community just to free a small number of slaves. At one point, he had been asked to rescue slave relatives enslaved in Charleston working at the salt works. With two former slaves, he went to travel to Charleston posing as a businessman. Associating himself with the slaveholders in Charleston, he persuades them to invest in a plan to build boats that carry salt from Kanawha's salt brines to be sold as profit. During this time, the freed slaves would look for their relatives. During the next two nights, the slaves are loaded secretly onto the boat and then released downriver. John Fairfield, pretending to be furious losing his boats, would raise alarms and send a search party to look for the missing slaves. Leading the party in the opposite direction of the way the escaping slaves are going, the slaves soon escape to freedom, which would eventually be led by John Fairfield to Canada. Many people think that John Fairfield was a very peaceful man, but John Fairfield was not afraid to kill anything that stood in his way when he was trying to defend himself for helping the slaves escape. The quote, "Slaveholders are devils, and it's no harm to kill the devil," shows that John Fairfield thought that in killing brought no harm to anyone. John Fairfield ironically dies in 1861 in a failed slave insurrection in Tennessee. He died from what he was doing best at, having accomplished of freeing thousands of slaves at his death. I believe that Abraham Lincoln best represents John Fairfield because of their perseverance for fighting slavery and their leadership qualities for being able to stand up for what they believe in. John Fairfield can be easily compared with the Boxer's Rebellion in the Western commercial because of their similar ideas of creativity and sneakiness. Also, both of them eventually resort to violence to get things done. This concludes my project about John Fairfield, the conductor, the rescuer.